action, kill that, turn the shoulder, hand comes round, go, I bring my hand to my chest, palm in, and then I bring it out. Okay? Sometimes people's arms will be out. So what I do to get the control of the arm is I bring it tight, okay? Elbow on the inside of my knee up, so I don't want him streaking out that way. And no matter where he goes with his arm, I'm going to track his biceps with my hip. So as he's moving, I know where it is. Even if it goes down the other way. But if you're talking it, you can't, by doing this, I'm stopping you from doing this over my shoulder. It makes it difficult for him. So just put my head. So even here, elbow in, I come up behind his head. Now as he's moving his arm around, just waiting for him. That's enough. So you can use your head on the bicep to track the arm. It isn't a case of trying to pin the arm with your head. Move your head with it. Alright, you'll pick up on the direction and you'll feel it turning. Because biceps will be moving against your head. Okay? So as you get it in here, I want to track it. I didn't. I did quite a bit of training years ago with Eric Paulson. Okay? Unbelievable, it was like an encyclopedia, it really is. And one of the ways he works with this is it's all about tracking from here. You're not trying to catch that wrist while it's in motion. So it doesn't matter how Josh moves that wrist around, if I'm here, and I'm just waiting, bit by bit, I'm just going towards where I want to be. Not here, and it moving around and me. Yeah?
That's cool.
Move your target. Yeah. So not only when you do that, you're lifting up to see it better. If you lift up, you're creating space. If you create space, you're giving the person a potential way out. This works well. Okay? Right, so off the back of this then. So we've gone here, the arm's out this time rather than over. But I don't want him getting a grip. Okay? Again, potentially I can thread that through and I can come back and start looking at reverse head and arm chokes, things like that. Let's play around with this a little bit. So as he moves his arm around, I pin. Okay? What I do from here is I track. And I come out, okay? I turn my hip and I step over his head. And I put his arm side of my head.
One more. One side of Rossi.
Yeah. We're all tracking. Then we just come out. I can even do it. If you haven't got a grip, watch. Pin the head, slide, step. I can even step here.
So I've got this position up.
Literally just wrap it. This stays in tight, so Josh. Stays in tight. Extend.
Literally crawl over. You jump, your weight goes. Your weight goes, and experienced person is waiting for that weight shift. That's where you want to move. So there's a bit of a combination of things you can do from there, secure it. They decide to take your arm out because they don't like how it's feeling, and you're out of traffic. You can still get the same submission. So we've got from this, the one that we were doing, kill the hip, roll the shoulder, submission. Okay. Same again. This time when I go to do that, he decides no thank you, I'm getting rid. And then I immediately bring the head into play. So wait for his arm to stop, moving around. And I catch it. Look, see how, even though I've not got the grip here, I use this arm to push it to that grip. And then I secure that one. Do you see? I'm not kind of, I haven't got it let go. I just use that one to extend it. Where my elbow is, puff it on his shoulder. That's it. And the other option is, he's moving it around, he puts it up inside the edge. So I pin, look, slide through. That's giving him something to think about, so she's over his neck. Shoulder to get up and go that way, so when that's all pinned, your weights are really sitting in the hips now. What direction left?